As one of the world's oldest living civilizations, India seeks to continuously discover and rediscover herself and conjures multiple meanings to different people. As we walk through India's long history, her linguistic, scientific, and artistic achievements over the centuries, your individual interpretation becomes your own meaning, your own Arth. For centuries, sages and seers have been trying to discover and catch a glimpse of this very soul of India, one that makes its appearance occasionally in the traditional musical styles of this country, our many dance forms, the multiplicity of our arts and crafts, our religions, faiths, scriptures, and rituals, the literary brilliance of our bards and writers. At the same time, paintings, sculptures, textiles, temples, our scientific discoveries and traditional knowledge, and most importantly, our very unique philosophy and approach to life as a whole. This Indic thought that has evolved over centuries of benign contemplation, debates, discussions, leading to discoveries, is one of the most liberal thoughts in the whole world. It's also perhaps one of the most democratic thought processes because it has evolved through consensus, through participation of people. The Indic mind has always been in pursuit of ananda or bliss or happiness, which is not merely restricted to materialistic happiness, but happiness in all its dimensions, and mind you, for every being on this planet. Being a civilization of seekers and not believers, we have always held that whatever discovery we have made, this is not the final word about it. It is just the beginning, a sojourn of a journey, a beautiful journey of more explorations, more discoveries coming our way. Panel discussions, debates, lectures by several eminent scientists, Indologists and scholars would of course be there, but most of the sessions would be interspersed with performances that are relevant to the theme that is being discussed. This would be a very unique way of curating the whole experience. Alongside, we would have numerous workshops by several artisans from different parts of the country. And each of you would get an opportunity to try your hands at learning a bit of that art. So do-it-yourself kind of art workshops where you can actually not only see them doing what they're doing, whether it's pottery or painting, but also try your hand at that. Special sessions curated only for children. We believe in catching them young. And so making children aware of different facets of our history and culture and heritage is going to be an important component of Arth. Alongside the different narratives of history, of Indian history, that have never been mainstreamed or brought out into the popular discourse would also get a platform on Arth, a Culture Quest. So be there on 8th, 9th and 10th of February 2019 at Arth.